Premier Media's Mining Weekly is speaking to Arnie Franson, the co-chief executive and co-founder of the Pallinghurst Group. Arnie Franson is also a chairperson of the New York-listed Novo Mondi Graphite, which is active in Canada in the field of graphite. He's also working with the government of Quebec in the field of lithium. And in South Africa, he has the stunning Sedi Belo Platinum Group Metals Mines. Arnie, your company is embracing maximum greenness at this hugely important time of COP26 taking place in Glasgow.
Yeah, no, you're right. And we were invited to participate, but we had work to do as well. So it is a very important time for the world. And I think that what you could hear yesterday from all ages, from Her Majesty 95 years old to the youngest child, pre-teenage, that gave an input, from islands in the Caribbean to Boris Johnson to countries in Africa outlining the consequences. I think we've now gone beyond it. It's time to act, not time to talk.
Now, after our last interview, the ink of Mining Weekly's report was hardly dry. We spoke about the construction of the Novomond Phase 1 graphite beneficiation plant in Quebec, your activities in lithium with Nemaska, and the construction of Sedi Belo's environmentally friendly platinum group metals. And as I said, the ink was hardly dry when up popped more news of more green activity, this time involving the acquisition of nearly 20% in a company that's involved in developing nickel, copper, and cobalt, Talon Metals. What does this mean now for your group and the pursuit of ESG?
Well, Martin, it's in line with what we set out to do. Again, I think it's important to go back 4 or 5 years before EVs and ESG and greenness was the talk of the town. We made as Pallinghurst a commitment to be a green mining company and to have a zero carbon footprint. And initially, when we had discussions both with investors and fellow players in the market, our mission statement was met with skepticism and we found very little support. However, I think that what we set out to achieve is now on everyone's mind, and even the sternest producer of coal or whatever of the big mining companies, iron ore, what have you, now realizes that the ESG agenda has to be an integrated part of how you conduct yourself as a mining company. And what our latest acquisition means is that we now have all the key elements that you need for the lithium-ion battery. And we have the key elements in platinum group metals that you need for fuel cells and the green hydrogen economy. So what we have been out doing for the past 3 years is really picking the assets. And we had the benefit of being ahead of the curve, and we got what we were looking for. I mean, In South Africa, obviously in Sedi Belo, we got a prime example of how progressive thinking can lead to a very sustainable source of PGMs. And I think we will play a very critical role in not only PGM production, but the entire green hydrogen economy. We are very much actively looking into that. And we will have a discussion about that, Martin, once we announce that. But it's for sure a firm commitment from our side. Talon Metals, again, the CEO is also out of the South African mold, Henry van Rooyen, and he is a formidable individual and is for sure making South Africa proud in Canada and the US. He has been developing together with his team an asset that arguably is North America's most exciting nickel prospect. And it also got, as you mentioned, cobalt and copper in the mix. So we will be able to make nickel sulfate, which obviously you need to have in any battery where you want to have some distance and some range. And again, given location, given the way we want to mine it, the way we want to process the material, we again setting up a very simple mission of zero carbon footprint and the ability to deliver those three critical cathode materials into the battery makers of North America and beyond.
I think it's so important to have that credibility that when you mine, you're also doing your best to protect Mother Earth. Just take us through some of the steps that you've taken to ensure that you are green at the site as well as in the market.
What we did, I mean, if you look at with all our assets in South Africa, we started not only with electricity, but also water. So up in the JOHANNESBURG, we have the catchment area with rainwater, and we have our own pipeline that supplies the mine. So again, we don't play with the groundwater, and we are in a situation where we also are supplying portable water for 35,000 people in the community. We then went into looking at how can we deliver metal with the lowest carbon footprint, and obviously the KELT technology plays a critical role in that. And we will lower our need for electricity with more than 80%. And then on top of that, we are now addressing the 18% that we are using and finding a solution where we don't have to burn coal in order to extract that. So all very exciting, and it all starts from a philosophy from the beginning. And we did the same with New Vermont. New Vermont, we 3 years ago, I sat down with the senior team at Caterpillar in North America. And again, initially, I guess they were skeptical given the fact that Caterpillar is the creator of arguably the best diesel engine in the mining industry. But they listened, and to their credit, we continued the dialogue. And 6 months ago, we announced that as the first mining company in the world, we formed a joint venture with Caterpillar in producing open cast, a total fleet that can service our mine. So again, that's the approach we take. We have the mine, a place where we are 100% supplied by hydro-generated electricity, so we're addressing that as well. We are addressing deforestation by planting trees and making sure that we maintain around our mine site a maximum cover of forest. And I guess it's about having it in your DNA. And that was how Andrew and I started out to do this 5 years ago. And I'm glad that it's working out the way that we hoped it would.
And how is the construction of Novamont's phase one graphite beneficiation plant going?
Well, I've been up being part of the commissioning. So it is really going as well as we could have hoped for. We're doing the last tests and improvements and all of that. But then we have a commercial line which can produce shaped, purified, coated graphite to put into the anode part of a battery. And it's the first time, Martin, that this has happened outside of Asia. And it is done in the most environmentally friendly fashion. And again, as when you do purification at high temperature, you're obviously using a lot of electricity. But again, our electricity is 100% hydro generated, so sustainable, renewable, and no carbon footprint.
That's fantastic. And your activities in lithium with Nemaska, can you update us on that?
Yeah, no, this is a very important part of our business, because I guess it's called the lithium-ion battery for a reason. But lithium is critical, and I think for whatever study you take down, Martin, from the shelf or you get off the internet, lithium is one of the materials that will be in short supply. And you and I know that building a mine is not like opening a bakery on or a corner shop or something, a cafe at the corner. This is actually something that takes time. And especially if you want to do it in a sustainable and environmentally friendly manner. So our project is going to be one of the largest of its kind in North America. We are hard rock, so it's spodumene, it's not brine. We're not playing with the water table again. And the mine itself, over the past years, a significant amount of money has been put into that. And we have also now located our site where we're going to build our hydroxide plant. We have secured that plant and we are starting preparing it for building our hydroxide chemical factory there. So it's really going full speed ahead. We have relocated 5 people to Canada to be part of this and experienced people. And I'm full of confidence. And I think that this is really an exciting project. And one that we again is doing in partnership with the Quebec government, which is our great partner.
And getting to City Bello, are you on budget and on time with your activities there? And when you talk about hydrogen in Canada, would there also be a possibility of green hydrogen activities in South Africa?
Martin, that is on the top of my wish list. No, absolutely. You will see that we will shortly announce a very key appointment that will be looking at exactly that field within Citabello. When I talked about addressing the 18% that we are still using of electricity compared to smelting, the entire hydrogen economy and solar and sustainability and renewable energy is right in the center of that thinking. So yes, we have a very simple plan. We want to produce the greenest ounce of PGM that can be produced, and we want to do it in a sustainable fashion and with a absolute minimum carbon footprint.
And so now that you've got all the metals and all the minerals you need, I'm not going to be surprised again by something else popping up.
Well, you should never say never, Martin. We are obviously always looking. I have a team that supports Andrew and Willis and myself, and they are very keen in the art of finding good deposits and all of that. But really, Martin, what is going to happen over the next couple of years is that we're all going to roll up our sleeves and we are going to get going and we are going to build. We have 3 big mines to build and 3 big converting facilities, as well as doing underground at Citabello and building our kelp plant. So my schedule is rather full, Martin, so I'm not looking for another day job.
And just to end off, how essential is it these days to subject companies to the full and unfettered demands of the environmental, social, governance principles, those 3 letters, ESG, which are dominating the corridors of political and corporate power these days?
Martin, it's essential. If you remember back when you and I had a conversation in early last year, where we talked about what needs to happen for the mining industry to become the darling of the investment community again, I said to you that it all starts in ESG. And that's really how it is. We need to show that we are house trained and that we are responsible members of the international community. And it can't be that we are producing material that is going to be critical for decarbonization and a greener future if they are being extracted not using the best of class ESG principles. So it's essential. It's our ticket to the board.
That was Creamer Media's Mining Weekly, speaking to Arnie Franson, the co-chief executive and co-founder of the Pallinghurst Group.